Hello, Foxtrot64 here again, back with another tutorial. Okay, I'm sure pretty much anyone who's ever wanted to record their desktop and used CamStudio to do so has noticed a very big problem that it has. If you record a file that is over 2 GB, or sometimes just for no reason at all it seems, CamStudio will come up with an error and the file will exist, but it will seem completely useless and incoherent and just a waste of space. This, for the most part, is entirely true, but I have figured out a way to fix that. And I'm going to explain that to you right now. I don't have a screen cap of the error that it comes up with, but I'm sure anyone who's used CamStudio has come across this problem at least once, because ooh, I know I've come up with this problem a lot when trying to record speed paints. In fact, it's the complete reason why I couldn't even do my first attempted speed paint. Anyway, what you'll do is you'll take the broken file, for instance, part 9 of this giant speed paint I'm working on that has 41 parts and is still only about halfway done. Fuck. Okay. For instance, part 9. This is in Virtual Dub, by the way, I forgot to mention that. I will give you a link of where to find and download Virtual Dub in the description below. For free. Okay, if you open the file, Virtual Dub will come up with reconstructing missing index block, and depending on a number of things, this can take a very short amount of time or a very long amount of time. In this case, it's gonna take a little while, so I'm just gonna skip to when it's done reconstructing the missing index block, and I'll see you then. Okay, when it finishes, it will pull up the video file here, and it will come up with a box here that says something like index could not be found or damaged, invalid chunk detected, keyframe flag, reconstruction, yada yada yada. Ignore that, it's really not important. It's basically a fancy-smancy way of telling you, hey, this file is fucked up. Which you probably already know. Okay, and the way to fix the fucked up file, well actually you could just go to video, or file, save as AVI, but you're going to end up with a huge file, so you definitely want to not do that. You definitely want to put some kind of compression on it. I still recommend the DivX 6.9.2 codec if your computer can handle it. If not, then Microsoft Video 1, PIC Video, whatever the heck you want to use, it's fine. And then for audio, well, I actually don't have any audio on this file, so I would just put no audio, but you would put full processing mode, compression, and again, choose some kind of compression that suits your needs. For right now, I'm just going to put no audio. And that's really all I need to do to this file right now. If I wanted to resize it or something like that, I could. Frame rate, I have found that I never really have to change, excuse me, the frame rate on a broken file, so that's fine. And I don't need to add any filters, as I said. So now I would just go to File, Save as AVI, name it something else. What I always do is do the same name as the file that you wanted, but put fixed after it. In this case, I will just put example, save. And it will come up with this typical thing that tells you it's compressing and fixing, basically, the video into what you want it to be. I believe I demonstrated this in my How to Make a Let's Play tutorial before, but if not, then this is what it looks like. The video rendering rate is basically how fast it's rendering the video. The projected file size is an estimate of how big the total file size is going to be, and I found that with the DivX codec, it can start out really big and then get really, really small, usually. Time elapsed, obviously, that's how much time it's been. Total time estimated is how long it thinks the whole thing is going to take, not how much time is left. Audio data, pretty self-explanatory. Video data, pretty self-explanatory. Current audio sample, pretty self-explanatory, and current video frame. That's the current frame that it's working on in the video that you're fixing right now. And after this is finished, you should end up with a video that you can use. If not, then there might be something wrong with the codec you picked. The video that CamStudio made might be broken for a different reason that I haven't seen yet. Who knows? Computers are just weird. But, this recording is already getting pretty far up there on the file size. So I think I'm just gonna stop recording right now. If this works for you, great. If it doesn't, please tell me so that I can maybe look up a solution or try to help you with that. I might be able to explain further. And if I can't help you beyond this, then I'm sorry. You might be beyond all hope, because this is the only solution for this that I have ever found or seen. And that is it for this tutorial, I believe. So, see you in the next one, if there ever is a next one, and until then, goodbye, sir.